there's something in your mind you cannot hide. You can try everything, you'll be high in the end. But there's something on your cheek that's flowing like a creek. Are there tears, or just dying memories? Keep doing what you do. All the stolen thief. Keep seeing what you say, but remember that everywhere. Be the stolen thief. Be the stolen thief. Be the stolen thief. Be the stolen thief, my friend.
Welcome to the video. All these subscribers and new subscribers, long-time viewers and new viewers, what we do here is we try to state the simple basic truth of what's actually going on in existence. Try to free you from the massive entanglement that is present here in this world. The spiritual teachings of this world are deplorable, in such bad condition here. And the effort to shine a light through all of that is very difficult. But it's something that needs to be done, because the teaching that everyone is familiar with here in the world is incomplete and substandard. Basically, if you boil it all down, you get the teachings that say that the dance of existence is has no purpose other than just simply to be the dance. That's all. It's just dancing for the sake of dancing. But that's not true. Very much not true. The dance of existence is dancing in order to help us forget what we are. That's its purpose. It's very, very purposeful. Everything in existence is very purposeful. Existence is all about purpose. The purpose is for spirit to forget that it is spirit, to forget that it is created by the prime creator. That is the purpose of all this dancing of existence. This is not pointed out in the world. It's ignored. This is the most important fact there is, because from this fact the entire situation easily gets exposed, laid bare, and clarified for what it is. But fudge on this fact and say something different and say, well, it's just all doing it. It's mysterious. Nobody knows why it's arising. I've heard all this my whole life. Evasion on this one all-important point. Virtually all the spiritual teaching on the planet evades this one all-important point. And through this evasion, everything else becomes confusing and cloudy. You must clarify this all-important point, and that is, existence is arising as a hypothetical scenario for the purpose of misleading spirit, deceiving spirit, and ultimately getting spirit to forget what it is. And this is taking place because spirit wants to be prime creator. And in order to be prime creator, spirit must forget that it was created by the prime creator. That is the etiology, the origins of all of this that we're experiencing. Without this fact, you will continue to flounder. With this fact, you find your feet on a rock, very solid position, and you're able then to see through the entire charade of existence. Realize that existence is really nothing but sickness. It's nothing but death, impermanence. All for the purpose simply of getting spirit to forget what it is. It's like a movie a spirit is watching, and in the watching of this movie, spirit is very forgetful of what it is. This movie is specifically being presented by mind for this very purpose, for spirit to forget what it is. Mind is the servant of spirit. Spirit chooses ideas, mind presents ideas. So mind is blameless in all of this. It's spirit that wants to be crime creator, not mind. Mind is simply presenting this hypothetical, plausible scenario of existence, of vulnerability and impermanence that gets spirit to forget what it is, because spirit is invulnerable and is eternal. Everything in existence is designed with the strategy and purpose of forgetfulness. Everything, entirety of it, including all the fake, false, misleading spiritual teachings, incomplete teachings, teachings that seem to be full of grandiose speech, but overlooks this one all-important fact. If one overlooks this all-important fact, then all the grandiose phraseologies in the world cannot compensate. There's no way to compensate. If you overlook the one essential, you spend all your time compensating for that, and there's never enough compensation. And satsang is all about hearing what you will not hear other places. Those who come to satsang and listen do so for the purpose of, because they're thirsty for the real truth, the real facts, the actual situation. They want to clarify it. They're tired of the world and existence. Very tired. They don't want to continue on with all of this. Satsang is really abiding in truth. Listening to truth. Sitting and listening to truth. And of course, then, truth needs to be spoken. Not spiritual platitudes. Not spiritual demagoguery. But the actual truth. This universe is purposeful. Completely purposeful. To get us to forget what we are. Of course, we can never become other than what we are. So this forgetting what we are is a continuous thing. And what happens when we stop, lessen our efforts to forget? Well, we start to remember what we are. That's all. So we either keep forgetting, or we start to remember. That's it. Just because something is forgotten doesn't mean it has ceased to be. Just because we've forgotten what we are doesn't mean what we are has ceased to be. We still are exactly as we were created. It's just that we have forgotten this. And so we think it's, you know, vanished. Can't find it anywhere. As we look in existence, we can't find what we are anywhere. No way. There's nothing in existence that reminds us, really, other than the saviors that come into the world, who know very well what they are. They were created by God, their spirit. But even those are set in a background of forgetfulness of this world. So we may get a little jolt of remembrance, but quickly we forget again. It's like we're in a deep, 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 deep sleep. One goes to sleep, one forgets that one is lying in a bed, so to speak. Deep, deep, deep sleep. We've gone into this very deep, deep sleep of forgetfulness. That's all it is. Of course, the one doing the forgetting is still the one spirit. Created by the Prime Creator. So all the spirit has to do is give up this desire to be Prime Creator, and it begins to remember what it is. It moves towards the overlay, which is the effect of the idea of giving up the attempt to be Prime Creator. There's no need to be forgetful, you see? So it's an effect of non-forgetfulness. Put it that way, the overlay is perfect non-forgetfulness. So when we forget, the remedy is not forgetting or non-forgetting. The overlay is this non-forgetting, so that as we look at the world, all we see is this non-forgetting. Whereas right now, all we see is this forgetting, no matter what we do. No matter how you slice the pizza, it's still a pizza. No matter what we do with this world, viewing it, it's still... its purpose is forgetfulness, and it adheres to this purpose. We don't know what we are. We have a strange feeling of being alienated from what we are. A feeling of incompleteness, of lostness, of estrangement. It's terrible feelings. It all comes from this forgetfulness. As we try to identify with this movie, thinking that we are, this movie defines us. Existence defines us. Existence does not define us at all. Zero. Zero definition of what we are. But as long as we believe that existence defines us, or we're supposed to be defined by existence because, quote-unquote, God created existence, and therefore existence must define us, as long as we believe that, we will be in deep forgetfulness of what we are. We are projecting existence. We're the ones responsible for it. Prime Creator is not doing this. Prime Creator did not create a scenario that would cause us to forget what we are. And so many spiritual teachings fail to point this out. They do say that it is forgetful, but they say that God is responsible for it. Nonsense. It's not true. It's a very severe mistake to make. The mind is presenting existence, the universe. And the mind is a servant of spirit. And spirit chose the idea of wanting to be Prime Creator, which then caused mind to present this dream movie of forgetfulness. That is what is happening. God, the Prime Creator, has nothing to do with this dream of forgetfulness. Absolutely nothing to do with it. We're responsible. Spirit is responsible. That's all important. I've studied so many spiritual teachings nonstop my whole entire life. And it's never clarified properly. It's very frustrating. How can anyone succeed in this world when it's never clarified properly? Very, very evasive, kind of compromised teachings that say that, for instance, if God made all of this, then why in the world would we want to wake up from it? It's completely contradictory. If God made everything in the universe and made us here and put us here, then we should embrace everything and not try to awaken from it, not seek enlightenment, not try to get free of it. That's ludicrous. Why would we want to get free of something that God created? So it's, you know, totally contradictory to say such things. And we say that we should get free of this, that we're deluded and deceived. How can we say that God made the deception and the delusion? God did not. The Prime Creator did not make it. This really has to be cleared up. This is just a gigantic, severe shortcoming in the teachings of this planet that has always been completely, blatantly obvious to me. When I came into this world, I just looked at the teachings and said, what's going on? This is so completely obvious. God, the Prime Creator, perfect, eternal, And they say that he, God the Prime Creator, created existence, and then we're completely confused and misidentified and deceived and suffering from all this. Really? 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 No, not really. Not at all. We're confused and deceived because we are trying to forget what we are. How can we be Prime Creator if we know that we were created? Obviously, the two cannot be both true. Cannot both be true, that we were, the Prime Creator created us and that we are the Prime Creator. Those two statements cannot both be true. This should be totally, blatantly obvious to anyone. So which is true? You see? If Spirit wants to be Prime Creator, then Spirit cannot recognize what it is. Because it is created by God the Prime Creator. So Spirit has to abandon one of those two positions. And if it wants to be Prime Creator, it has to abandon God the Prime Creator and try to forget what it is, because it was created by the Prime Creator, and Spirit knows this. So it has to forget what it is. It has to try and forget what it is. It has to. And this world is nothing but forgetfulness. Vulnerability is forgetfulness. Impermanence is forgetfulness. Decay, sickness is forgetfulness. All this change, constant change, is forgetfulness. Reality isn't this way at all. There's no sickness, there's no impermanence, there's no dying, there's no death in reality at all. None. So how could God possibly perpetrate such an unbelievable fraud upon Spirit? The fact is, God did not. We don't have to shake our head and shrug our shoulders and say, well, I don't know, it's a mystery, etc. Nonsense. It's not a mystery at all. It's totally obvious, blatant, right in front of us. Has always been this way, completely obvious. The fact that it's not obvious to us means we're trying to forget what we are. Plain and simple. Spiritual teaching is not difficult. It simply says truth and lies can't both be true. It cannot be both true that we were created by the Prime Creator and we are the Prime Creator. Those two statements cannot both be true. Impossible. And yet we kind of go into some kind of coma where we profess to say that we don't see that. It's vague and cloudy and fuzzy, and we say, you know, I'm not really sure about that. That's a deep, deep sleep. Deep confusion. Very groggy and hazy. That's very simple. Very simple. How can that which was created claim that it is the Prime Creator? It cannot. It's obviously a lie. Obviously a lie. Okay? And obviously, equally obvious is the statement that the Prime Creator created Spirit and Spirit is the Prime Creator. Those can't both be true. That's equally obvious. Totally obvious. So, we have a world that is steeped in tremendous confusion. And the spiritual teachings have not risen to the level of shining through that confusion. And so we just continue to flounder. I look at so many people, their profiles, and where they're at, what they're looking at, the information that they see as valuable, the thoughts that they have, the comments they have. I have to assess, where is the world coming from? Where is each person coming from? Where is it? And it's just completely obvious that it's not yet clear that truth and lies can't both be true. That Spirit cannot be Prime Creator if God is Prime Creator. Cannot both be true. So there is a lack of focus on this. My purpose is to get the focus where it needs to be. Not to solve other problems of the world. Because the problems of the world, the way things are set up, will never be solved except by choosing a new idea. By dropping the attempt to be Prime Creator. That's the only way. Because everything else is simply an attempt to forget. The problem is, spirit cannot forget what it is. And the effort to forget is miserable. That's the problem. It will always be miserable. The effort for spirit to forget what it is will always be miserable. And yet, what spirit is demanding of teachers is that to make this effort pleasant. It's impossible. And if anyone comes and says, you know, I want things to be pleasant, I want things to be better, well, but without seeing the obvious that truth and lies can't both be true, well, that's an impossible task to give anyone. It would never be accomplished. The effort for spirit to forget what it is inherently has to involve conditions that are opposite of reality. So here you have all sorts of deviousness and sneakiness and deception and betrayal and terror and fear, confusion, doubt, despair, frustration, darkness, deceits of all kind, illusions, mirages, death, vulnerability, harm, sickness, afflictions, ups and downs, whatever you get gets taken away, disasters, catastrophes, etc. All those things, they have to be part of your experiencing in order to forget what you are. If you didn't have all this terrible, terrible, terrible stuff, you'd remember what you are. You'd say, oh, I remember. So you can't have your cake and eat it too. In order to forget, you have to have this terrible situation. If you didn't have it, you'd remember. So those who say they want, you know, things to be made, you know, pleasant, they want pleasant forgetting, it's impossible. If things become too good and too good here, then remembering will start to kick in. Remembering kicks in anyway, because we don't really, we're tired of this forgetting. So it's impossible to forget without having a situation here which is causes a great deal of forgetfulness. Identifying with the body certainly does that. One of the ways to identify with the body is to try to make life pleasant. One thinks, oh, this world isn't so bad. I can keep on, you know, believing in it. That too is a very dark, deep deception. This existence is terrible. I know there's a whole line of spiritual belief that existence is great. We can make it much better. We're meant to embrace it and evolve with it, and you know, that is all nonsense. It has to be terrible. Now they say, well, the path of remembering can be very wonderful as we gradually remember. There is some elements of truth to that, but can very easily become twisted into trying to make existence a very pleasant place, which it cannot be. Because that's working at the level of effects. Working at the level of effects will never solve the situation, because it leaves intact the belief that we can truly forget what we are and recreate ourselves anew as Prime Creators. It leaves that intact. As long as that's intact, the forgetfulness will have to be severe here. Severe. So you may have phases that seem pleasant, but those are replaced by phases that are terrible. So we deceive ourselves through cycles of existence, where we do have times where we seem to go up, things get better, and suddenly the downturn comes. So you must be very, very wary of that. And that's why I emphasize, turn your attention to the very root of the situation. Do not think that simply improving the conditions of this planet is somehow progress. You will find sudden reversals of fortune. Do not think that just good health is somehow progress. You may suddenly find yourself succumbing to some malfunction. Okay? Body's completely vulnerable to dying, to sickness of almost infinite types. Don't think just because you're rich that things are getting better for you. Your accountant may embezzle everything. One day you wake up and you find out you don't have anything. Everything that you have in this world can be snatched away from you. No matter how good you think you have it. And there again, that just gives powerful forgetfulness to you. Because in reality, nothing can be taken away from you. Nothing whatsoever. Where here, everything can be taken away from you. So don't fall into the trap, or don't remain in the trap that you're in, of improvement. No, you want to choose a new idea. The situation here is not one of process, it's one of choice. It's not a process of getting better, it's a choice of choosing to not be prime creator, not try and be prime creator. That's the choice. That's what resolves the entire situation, because then you get the effect of non-forgetting. You cannot keep the attempt to be prime creator and still not forget what you are. That's impossible. And everyone here is trying to do the impossible. That is my testimony. As I have looked at the world, evaluated the world for 55 years, it's totally obvious. Everyone here is trying to accomplish the impossible, thinking that they have the willpower and the heart and the love and the creativity and everything that they were created with, that can all be used to accomplish this. Cannot. There's nothing that God created that can accomplish the impossible. That's not its purpose. Nothing that God created that can be separate from God, that can be prime creator. It's not possible that all the attributes that Spirit has cannot be used to accomplish the impossible. But we believe that they can. We believe that mind can somehow accomplish this. We have the capability to do it. Everybody, no one may be directly stating this, but this is actually what's guiding everyone's purpose here and destiny on this planet. And throughout the universe is the attempt to accomplish the impossible. Have a cake and eat it too. Maintain the desire to be prime creator, but somehow have a situation which is not unpleasant, which is stable. You cannot have conditions in existence that are very close to conditions of reality, because Spirit would then remember what it is, and it would know that it's not prime creator. So you see the bind that we're in, that you are in, that we are all in existence. As we keep playing with this edge, you know, how close can we, how good could we make the situation in this world without remembering what we are, so that we can continue to believe that we can be prime creators. And there's an ebb and flow to this, constant flux. It's like a dancing with fire. It's all very stressful, very frustrating. Gets us nowhere. It's all a waste of time. What does it really accomplish? Absolutely nothing. Doesn't make us prime creator. Doesn't establish a permanence of forgetting. Doesn't change the fact we have to choose a new idea to truly remember what we are. So it's just simply a waste of time. Ultimately, all this tricky dance that we're doing is simply a waste of time. Just a delay. Accomplishes nothing. You'll never, ever, never, never, never be able to accomplish the impossible and be prime creator. Never. Never is the most important word on the spiritual path, by far. Never, impossible, those two. It's easy to tell where you are on the path towards choosing a new idea by how you react to the word never. If you love the word never, 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 say, I just love that word, most important word there is, then you know for sure that you are closing in on choosing a new idea, the idea of not trying to be prime creator, which gives the effect of non-forgetting, which is the overlay, as I call it. It's the vision of Christ, vision of oneness, peace beyond understanding, Krishna consciousness, Christ consciousness, vision of Christ. All those things, that's what's referring to the overlay, the effect of the idea of not trying to be prime creator. It's the effect of non-forgetting. So this effect reminds us of what we are, meaning this effect is permanent, unchanging, invulnerable, uncorruptible, stable, beautiful, blissful. unaffected by the dance of existence, by the dance of forgetfulness. Completely unaffected, but it overlays it all. This is the great pearl, a pearl of great price. Jesus said, sell all of your jewelry and use the money to buy this pearl of great price. This is what it is. And words like never and impossible lead us to this pearl of great price. Because as long as we keep believing we can accomplish the impossible, we will continue to grab at lesser jewels. Jewels of compromise. And those are very, very dissatisfying to us. No matter what kind of brave face we put on, it's very dissatisfactory. We're frustrated and by it all. Something lacking. Always something lacking, which is why we're constantly trying to accumulate more. And I guarantee you, from my association with some of the wealthy people and rich, famous people, they're not satisfied at all. They have exactly the same feeling of lack as anyone else. Just desperately searching for some way to fill that lack. I've associated with all entire spectrum of people on this planet. They all have exactly the same problem. Feeling of lack. They just all go about it in different ways, how to try and fill that lack. All different sorts of strategies. None of them work. None of them will ever work. They will never work. Because the purpose of existence doesn't work. Spirit can never become prime creator, never be prime creator. Spirit can never entirely forget what it is. All forgetfulness is just a temporary situation. As soon as we start to lessen our efforts, we start to remember. It's just like sleep is temporary. We're sleeping in the bed. We can't sleep forever. Eventually, we'll wake up. And we keep trying to remain asleep, trying to remain asleep, trying to dream dreams that seem very interesting. Let's say we're sleeping, we're dreaming, and we start to wake up. We say, I don't want to wake up yet. So let's work on this dream and get it going again and make it really exciting and thrilling and dangerous. So I'll really focus on the dream and won't wake up. We've all done that. Sort of in a half-sleep state. We try to pull ourselves back into sleep. This is what we're doing on a much grander scale. The play of consciousness, so to speak, is just this dream. We keep trying to find better plays of consciousness, which just means keeping ourselves asleep. Forget about consciousness. Choose a new idea, and mind will present the effect of non-forgetfulness. To overlays consciousness, overlays everything that arises in consciousness, overlays the entire dream, including the dreamer who seems to be experiencing the dream. Overlays all of that. That is the remedy. And this is what is taught here in the satsang. North Shore here. We're using this as a backdrop, very peaceful, very beautiful, very suitable type of backdrop. Everybody just chills out here and listens to the truth, considers the truth. It's not easy because all the compromised positions that we have entertained seem to be what is holding us together. And we feel without it we'll have total instability. Not true, because never is very stable. Impossible is very stable. Truth and lies can't both be true is very stable. So build your clarity on this true stability. Because we cannot right now directly know what we are. We're so enmeshed. We can do it, but we choose not to because we're so enmeshed in all this instability that we feel be too much of a leap of discontinuity to simply, once again, completely be what we are, know what we are, with zero forgetfulness. So, and then we fear the complete flow of our functioning. So what we do first is we choose the idea not being prime creator, and we get the effect of non-forgetfulness, which is entirely stable. And yet we're not flowing on to other ideas yet. We're just abiding in this total stability of non-forgetfulness. And we abide in that, and abide in that, and then finally the prime creator says, okay, you're ready to flow in the play of ideas as you were created to do, and that will happen at the appropriate moment, but we're not concerned with that. Everything here is concerned about abiding in the stability of non-forgetfulness of what we are. And that stability, that effect, comes from choosing the idea of not trying to be prime creator. Very simple teaching. It's time that we get it right. And I invite everyone here to subscribe, everyone who watches the videos to subscribe, and other satsangs will be presented that reinforce this for you. It's all important truth. Okay, very great. That's it.
Maybe you think the people would fall into your traps, look better around you, there's nothing but your light. You're lost in your mind without no compass. You can try to pinch yourself and wake up fast. Keep doing what you do, but remember that anyway, you are the stolen thief. Keep saying what you say, but remember that everywhere, you'll be the stolen thief, 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 my friend. Keep doing what you do, but remember that anyway, you are the stolen thief. I keep saying what you say, but remember that anyway.